I guess my first question is, why did you guys decide to sue?
Well, we're just appalled that they, essentially the Washington State Department of Fish and Wildlife has kept the bear hunting program going all these years, even after the voters, by two initiatives, said that these types of hunting were cruel and unacceptable in the state of Washington. So baiting, using dogs and traps were outlawed in the state of Washington by two voter initiatives. And so we were appalled to find out that the state of Washington Department of Fish and Wildlife has continued to use these practices under this loophole of depredation. But in reality, what's occurred is they've simply institutionalized a bear hunting program by another name.
So let's talk about that.
No.
Why does your organization believe that this is not a program that targets problem bears, that it's just a general hunt?
Well, because there's the way in which these depredation permits are granted, it's totally unclear that any of the bears killed are the bears that are actually doing the depredation. In essence, what the permits are allowing is just a total annihilation of bears in the areas where some depredation has been reported. And so it's assuming that any bear they see anywhere within a few miles of this event is the guilty bear. And that's just not, they don't know that, first of all. And second of all, this is the type of, you know, bears, when they come out of hibernation, are looking for food. And when you have plantation forestry, this and all even age, you know, you clear cut the area, plant the trees that are all the same age, this is the kind of thing that is going to occur. And so the ultimate solution to this is a better form of forestry that doesn't create this monoculture plantations that have the problems for the bears, because bears have existed in the forests here in the Northwest for just tens of thousands of years, even time immemorial. And there always is some, you know, the bears will scratch the bark of trees, and they do kill some trees, but in a forest setting, this isn't a problem. In the plantation, it becomes a problem for the forestry company, and they've teamed up with the Department of Fish and Wildlife in this unholy alliance to be slaughtering our bears. And it's illegal. It's been outlawed. These forms of bear hunting have been outlawed in the state of Washington, and it's morally repugnant, and it's simply wrong.
The timber owners, foresters may say, we have no choice. We have to do this because they are taking our profits. I've had a forester say the bears literally are taking from his 401k. So is there sympathy for their side of it, or is it just like, you've got to figure this out and it's not our problem?
Well, of course there's sympathy for anybody dealing with a difficult situation, but the reality is, the voters in the state of Washington have passed two initiatives that clearly ban this type of cruel hunting. And so at this point, what we're looking at is just a wholesale exemption to that state voter initiative, that the Department of Fish and Wildlife has basically created this, taken a what was allowed a small exemption in the voter initiative and driven a Mack truck through it with this indiscriminate bear killing program that allows hounding, it allows trapping. It's repugnant and horrible. And so, yeah, of course we have sympathy for people dealing with their situation, but it's simply not acceptable for the people of the state of Washington, for our members, for our organization to allow this to occur. And most importantly, the voters of the state of Washington have already decided that these methods are not lawful.
The state says we're working it out. We just need some time to create a group of stakeholders who are going to get together and flush out all these problems. Why not let that process work instead of suing? Why sue?
Well, you know, it's a little bit disingenuous for the state to be asserting this at this time. This has been going on for a number of years. People have raised concerns about this for quite a few years. They've had a lot of time to address and try to come up with some solutions. And frankly, we think the only reason that they've accelerated their rhetoric of trying to find a solution is that they know this lawsuit is coming. And so we're more than happy to help try and find some reasonable solution, but let's do it in a way that's enforceable through through the court, because ultimately we can't take their word. They've violated the public trust, violated the law, and we need to have whatever solution is going to come from this be ratified by a court, and so it's actually enforceable.
Why now? Why did you guys
do it now? Well, because this is the time of year when depredation permits are being issued, and so as the bears come out of hibernation, permits are being issued to kill the bears, and this is the time of year when that occurs. So we decided we couldn't wait any longer in terms of waiting another year or waiting another 2 years, because we feel very strongly that the law has been being violated for over 15 years, and it's time to put a stop to this.
I know there are some critics who say the Center for Biological Diversity isn't even based in Washington. You guys are suing over the wolves. And now you're suing over bears. Why not just let the people of Washington work it out?
Well, we are the people of Washington. We have thousands of members in the state of Washington. We have staff members in Seattle here. So we are part of the state of Washington. And we have every right to challenge this, and we intend to. This plantation forestry concept, when this is the difference between there are methods of forestry, and this is, I guess, what's important, because what is the solution? There are methods of forestry that can be done that don't call for plantations. See, this is the problem. It's not that it's not inherently a problem that timber companies are managing the forest. That doesn't necessarily have to hurt bears, or bears don't necessarily interact in a way that even, you know, if they kill a tree here and there from scratching on the bark, it's not a big deal, right? It's when you have a plantation and you've created a monocrop. You've clear cut whatever was there before, the old growth forest that was there before. You've replanted this monoculture of a plantation. The bottom line is, when you have plantation forestry, you run into all kinds of problems with disease outbreaks. You run into all kinds of problems like this. And so the solution is a more ecological type of forestry that doesn't call for these types of plantations. And in the meantime, if that can't be accomplished, or they've got some difficulty in getting to that place, the state of Washington has said you can't kill bears in these ways, and by the voters. And so the Department of Fish and Wildlife is trying to thwart the will of the voters.
Well, they are not allowed to do it to just indiscriminately kill bears. They are saying, basically, right, the law says, the loophole says that there has to be a specific problem animal that's targeted.
Look,
right?
If we have...
Are you guys okay with that? If they were to say, hey, we're going to figure out a way to target problem bears in order to continue using this hunting method.
No, we're actually not okay with this. We're not okay with baiting, hounding, you know, killing bears by baiting, hounding, or trapping under any circumstances. However, in this particular lawsuit, the law in question is what we're pressing the issue of. In essence, the state of Washington has created a hounding, trapping program using the guise of depredation. If we were to apply the same types of evidentiary proof to people that we're looking at for bears, in essence, what you would say is a crime was committed in this neighborhood, just round up all of the people that you see in that area. We would look at that and say, that's outrageous. You can't just simply start rounding up people who may or may not be the person responsible for what you're concerned about. And this is what they're doing with bears, is they're saying, okay, a problem exists, just get rid of the bears in this area. And that's it's untenable, and it creates, over the years, what they've done with this broad scale expanding the depredation exemption. They've basically created a hounding trapping program under another name.
So is your preference then it just be a change in forestry, or is there an option in your organization's mind for killing bears at all? Or does that just totally have to stop with your goals in this lawsuit?
Yeah, we believe that bears should not be killed unless there's some actual threat to human life, or to some very serious situation. A bear killing some trees in a plantation forest, no, we don't believe that that's a valid reason to kill a bear.
But that's not what the law.
That's correct. That's right. You've asked me what our organization's opinion is, and I've given it to you. In this particular lawsuit, we're challenging the program that the Washington State of Fish and Wildlife has enacted using the depredation exemption. And we feel like this is a gross distortion of the depredation exemption. It's created literally a program in which hundreds of bears are killed annually. And we're very solid on the facts and the law that we are correct and the court will rule in our favor.
And what ultimately do you want?
Well, what we ultimately want is for bears that have lived in the state of Washington and throughout the western United States to be able to live their lives free of human interference.
Is that possible?
Sure it is. Absolutely. This is an enormous state. I mean, the reality is bears can live with people. The question is, are people going to be able to live to adjust their activities to accommodate the bears who have been here for a really, really long time?
Do you ever worry, though, that a lawsuit forces a solution onto a situation that maybe not all parties agree with, and thereby you don't have the entire community engagement, and it could cause problems down the road?
Well, I mean, it would obviously the best thing would be to have people voluntarily, you know, come to the decision of, yeah, this is not the right thing to kill bears with hounds and traps. Sure, that would be the best thing. But, you know, it's not a perfect world, and that's one of the reasons why we have laws and courts and the ability of citizens to bring their grievances to courts, because unfortunately, you know, not everybody can agree on these things, and this is the best solution in a civil society to address these disputes. If you can't reach agreement with the person that you're having a disagreement with, is ultimately, if that goes on for a long enough period of time and you just can't figure it out, then filing a lawsuit is absolutely within our right. And you can see in a lot of other areas of society how changes have been made, including, you know, school desegregation. You could look at just a host of issues and say that it was through litigation that social progress was made.